107. Okay, right. So your homework, you had to look at compound words, okay? So, Duck, can you read what a compound noun is?
A compound noun is made from at least two separate words joined together. Bread plus tin equal bread tin.
Yeah.
Most compound nouns are written as two separate words, but they can also be written as one word or written using a hyphen.
A hyphen.
Hyphen.
Do you know what a hyphen is?
No.
Okay, let me show you what a hyphen is, okay? So look at my circle that I've drawn on my board. Can you see that dash? Everybody say hyphen.
Hyphen.
Okay. So Moon, what is a compound noun?
A compound noun is made from at least two separated words joining together.
Yeah, two separate words joined together to make one word, okay? Everybody, let's do it together. Show me two fingers. Say two separate words.
Two separate words.
Join together. Make one word. Awesome, cool. So that was your homework. You had to look at two separate words, bring them together to make one word. Okay. Susu, can you read number one for us?
We built a dog house for our new puppy to live in.
Good. Cherry, can you read number two?
Have a fish plus light. A flashlight in case of it get dark.
Yeah, is in case it get dark or it gets dark?
Gets dark.
Okay, so we've got flash, light, two separate words, bring them together, one word, okay? Number three, banana.
Please use neat handwriting when you do your homework.
Good, so we've got hand and writing, two separate words, we bring them together to make one word, yeah? Okay, Mango, can you read number four?
I saw an orange butterfly fluttering in the garden.
Excellent, so we've got butterfly, bring them together to make one word, butterfly, good. Sophia, can you read number five?
Mark read his
Rosie, can you read the next sentence?
Please don't touch your window with dirty hand. You leave a thump. I don't know this one.
What's that word say? Oh, you don't know it? Thumbprint. Yeah, so everybody look at your thumb. Everyone look at your thumb. And can you tell me what pattern you have on your thumb? So we all have different patterns. We all have different thumbprints, right? So I'll show you what mine looks like. And you can draw yours if you want and show me. So mine thumbprint looks like this. It's like waves. It goes up and down. Can you show me your thumbprint? Maybe you can.
My thumbprint like a wiggly snail.
Yeah, so some go round and round like a snail, like this. You have to draw it because I can't see your thumbs on here. Some go round and round like this. Oh, let's have a look at Taylor's. Taylor, come closer to the camera. Ah, yours are like arches, yeah? That's cool. Yours are curves. Awesome. Rich. Let's have a look at number seven. Ray, can you read number seven?
I have to go out and play in the sunshine.
Good boy. So we have sun, shine, two separate words. We bring them together to make one word. Good. And can I have Sam, can you read number 8?
In the summer time, we like to go to the pool.
Yeah, nice. Good. So we got summer time, bring them together, summertime. Awesome. Okay. So you can put your reader's notebook to the side now. And you need to be on this page on your journeys book, okay? Looking at weather.
Page 265.
What page number?
265.
Okay, cool. So page 265, and then show me that you're on the page so I can see who's ready and who can read, okay? So okay. Mill, I would like you to read the first paragraph about weather, please.
What?
Can you read the paragraph about weather?
Okay, did you ever wonder about the weather? Most people like when the weather is sunny, sometimes.
Though.
Sometimes the weather can cause problems.
Wait. Good reading. Can you say sometimes though the weather can cause problems?
The weather can cause problems. When it rains or snows, you may have to stay inside. Some weather can even be dangerous. Tornadoes and hurricanes are two kinds of dangerous storms. You will read about some types of dangerous weather in superstorms.
Excellent, good job. Can anybody tell me a story or a time that you got caught in a storm? What was it like? What did you see? What did you feel? Can you raise your hand and share with me a crazy storm you might have seen? Benten, can you tell us about a storm you have seen before? Because in Hanoi, you get lots of amazing storms. Can you unmute?
But China's got me.
When I was going home with my mother and my baby, I can't see a very, very long crack thunderstorm has cracked on a field. It did, but it didn't fire it.
Oh, wow. So it actually, you saw it flash down onto a field.
Yes, but it didn't fire it.
Oh, it didn't make fire. That's an amazing story. That's so cool. Wow.
I think it didn't make fire because of the water.
Why because of the water? What do you mean?
Because the water stopped the lightning from firing.
Oh, does it? Okay.
I think that.
Oh, I thought maybe okay, so it stops it from making fire. I see. Cool. Nice story. Thank you. That's amazing. Has anybody got other stories about storms? Storms, Taylor.
When I was learning Vietnamese online at home, there was a storm at the window, and it was a very big window, and I forgot to close it. And the water go inside, and I am too wet, and I said that, what's that thing? And I see the storm outside, and I close the door, and I said, oh my gosh.
Oh no, yeah, because you don't want to flood your house, do you?
Yeah.
Sometimes I leave my windows open and then the storm comes and then I have loads of water, loads of rainwater in my kitchen and I'm like, oh no!
Me too!
Window! Yeah,
we
have lots of amazing storms in Hanoi. You have lots of lightning across the sky.
But I have one of the craziest stories.
I don't
hear that! Okay. Let me just see if anybody else has a story they want to share about a storm. Okay, let's hear yours, Benten.
Okay. When I was watching a video, I noticed in the video was a grandfather was walking on the road, but a lightning struck him and fell to the ground. But a minute later, he stood up. and it goes again and again.
No.
But he still survived.
That's so unlucky. He's still alive. Well, that's so good, isn't it?
Destructed three times that he was still alive.
Wow, he's amazing. He's very amazing person to stay alive after three strikes.
What? Yes.
Benton, can you say it again? I cannot hear what Benton.
I said that when I was watching a video, I noticed in a video there was a grandfather who was walking on a road. A lightning struck him. He fell to the ground, but a minute later he stood up and it's still going again. After three strikes, he was still alive.
Wow, that's amazing. Is lightning very dangerous?
I saw that it was dangerous.
Yeah.
But what I think that grandfather was doing very brave.
Yeah. What happens if you get struck by lightning? What can happen to you? Do you know?
Just got your skeleton out of your body.
Oh, yeah. Mango.
Miracle dust.
You will become ash.
You'll become ash. Oh, my goodness. It will scorch you. Yeah.
I know that story already.
Ah, okay. It looks like you've watched cartoons. But if you get struck by lightning, you get electrocuted. Yeah, and it can be very, very dangerous.
Yes, so
but I think that grandfather was covered in water.
Oh, so he did get electrocuted because of the water.
One time I touched electricity already. I didn't become ash.
Okay, yeah. Is it safe to go outside when it's lightning?
Yes.
You think?
Yes, so we can turn into a super.
Oh, so then maybe you have superpowers when you get struck by lightning.
Struck by lightning, what I wanted to be.
I think you've seen too many movies. Okay, Mango,
electricity.
Yeah.
But when Milk said when he got struck by lightning, he will have a superpower, but everyone will use him as a charging station.
That's very funny, Mango. Yeah, maybe we will charge our phones from Milk. That will be his superpower.
Yeah.
Okay, awesome. Right, let's move on. So visualize.
They have to stay away from.
Yeah, we'll get an electric shock. Yeah. Okay, Jack, what does visualizing mean?
Visualizing means mental pictures that as I read like a movie playing in my brain.
Okay, so you can use your own words, not the words on the screen. So visualizing is when you make a picture in your head as you read, yeah? Do you remember in the class, I would get you to close your eyes and you had to visualize a big elephant with a hat that went up to the clouds and then there was a mouse on top of his hat and he was a pink elephant, yeah? With a big bottom, yeah? So visualizing is when you create pictures in your head. So we will visualize through our story today, okay? And it helps you imagine the story. Okay, let's go on. Genre, what does genre mean? Bunny, what does genre mean?
The style of story.
Good girl. Bunny, can you give me some examples of genres? What different genres do you know?
Realistic fiction.
Yeah.
Fiction.
Yeah. What's the scary ones called?
Oh. Horror.
Horror. What's the really old ones that have lots of lessons in them, lots of morals?
Folktale,
fables, yeah. So we've got, look at my screen. We can have mystery, fantasy.
What about legends?
Yeah, you can have humorous fiction, which is funny stories. Yeah.
I want to read some mystery stories.
Yeah, well, me we haven't too. Seen
and history yet, fiction. Have
we? Yeah, we haven't seen those yet. We've done a lot of informational text and realistic fiction this year.
No.
Okay.
Science fiction, realistic fiction, fantasy, and mystery have in a frickle.
Ah, okay, cool. So our story today is going to be informational text. And where's Misha? Is Misha here?
Lati.
Yeah.
But what is myth, like, legend, drama, and poetry?
So myths are like really, really old stories about like gods and things like this, yeah? So myths are stories that might not be true, yeah, but they're very, very old stories.
The down one and the last line.
And the last line, legends will be about, legends are very famous people. So it's a story about very famous people, yeah? Old stories about very famous people. And drama is lots of problems and solutions in it. And poetry is, you know what poetry is. You can have like, you can have little paragraphs that rhyme. Yeah, so they tell like a very little story and they use a lot of rhyming words.
We didn't get to read mystery. We didn't get to read how many, 5 kinds of genre.
Yeah, but there's so many genres in the world. There's lots and lots and lots and lots of different genres, okay? So Puppy, today we're gonna read a story that's an informational text. What things do you see in an informational text?
They were very informational.
So they will give us information, yeah? What does that mean? Will it be true or false?
Facts.
Yeah, so it's lots of facts. Do we have photos or illustrations? Puppy, photos or illustrations?
Photos.
Yeah, photos. And do we have things like captions and labels and graphs?
Yes.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so these are the features. These are things we see in informational text. Awesome. Okay, Moon, can you read the first paragraph about the author, Seymour Simon? Okay, it's very hard to hear you, Moon, for some reason. Susu, how many books has Seymour Simon written?
200 books.
Yeah, more than 200 books. He's a busy writer, isn't he? Susu, you need to pay attention, okay? Awesome, so he likes to write about things like bats and bears and snakes and bugs and sharks, okay? So he loves science. Okay, so let's look at our front cover, Superstorms by Seymour Simon. So we're gonna set a purpose, which means why would we read Superstorms? So Misha, what's your purpose? Why do you want to read
Superstorms? I want to read Superstorms because I want to...
Different storms?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. So you want to learn about different storms and I want to know what a superstorm is. Awesome, thank you, Misha. Okay, Mango, making a prediction by looking at the front cover, what do you predict our story will be about?
I predict a story about will be about storms.
Yeah, good. And what can you see on that front cover? You know, you can see the flash of light. What do you think might be in the book?
I think it was lightning.
Yeah, we will learn about lightning, yeah?
I thought it was thunder.
Yeah, no, this is lightning. Thunder is the noise you hear. You know you hear thunder and then you have lightning after? Okay, so let's read the first page. Taylor, can you read the first page for us?
Okay.
The air around us is always moving and changing. We call this changes weather. Some are studies following change in weather.
Okay, listen to me, yeah, Taylor? Storms are sudden, violent changes in weather.
Storms are steady.
Wait. Say storms are sudden.
Storms are sudden.
Storms are sudden.
Storms are sudden.
Violent.
Violent changes in weather.
Good girl. Taylor, do you know what violent means?
No.
It means they destroy. It's like destructive. It damages things. So it says storms are sudden, so they're fast. They're violent, so they destroy things. Yeah? So that's okay. Cool. Good girl. Nice reading. Okay, let's have a look. Where's Banana? Banana, can you read the next page?
Every second hundred of thunderstorm.
Is this a thunderstorm or thunderstorms?
Thunderstorms are born around the world. Thunderstorms are heavy rain showers. They can drop millions of gallons of water in just 1 minute.
Excellent. That's amazing. That's so much water, isn't it? Good reading, Banana. Thank you. Okay, let's go to the next page. I'm going to ask Rosie, can you read this page for us? Rosie, okay, read this paragraph.
During a thunderstorm, lightning
bolts
can shoot between cloud and ground. Lightning can destroy a tree or a small house. It can also start fire in the forest and grassland. Thunder is the sound lightning makes as it suddenly hits the air. You can tell how far away lightning is. Count the second between the flash of light and the sound of thunder. 5 seconds equal 1 mile.
Yeah, good. Remember your S's, okay? So you need to say, count the seconds between the flash of light, yeah? Awesome. Okay, so let's reread the paragraph on page 271. And what is the main idea of the paragraph? So everybody needs to think. I will read it. You need to tell me what is the main idea? What is it telling you about? Okay, so listen, and I will ask you the main idea. During a thunderstorm, lightning bolts can shoot between clouds and the ground. Lightning can destroy a tree or a small house. It can also start fires in forests and grasslands. Thunder is the sound lightning makes as it suddenly heats the air. You can tell how far away lightning is. Count the seconds between the flash of light and the sound of thunder. 5 seconds equal 1 mile. Okay, so what is the main idea? What is the author trying to tell us about? What are they trying to teach us? Ray?
The main idea of the first paragraph. The main idea of the first paragraph is how lightning can harm land.
Yeah, excellent, good. So that's really good, Ray. So it's telling us about the dangers of lightning. Yeah, that's what you said. Good boy. So our main idea here in this paragraph is all about the dangers of lightning, how dangerous lightning is. Do you agree? Yeah, that's our main idea. Okay. So now we have the main idea. What are the details? that support the main idea that lightning is dangerous? So what are the details? So Bunny, can you give me one detail that tells us that lightning is dangerous?
It can also start fire in forests and grasslands.
Awesome, great detail, good. Let me ask Sophia for one more detail. Can you give us one more detail that tells us lightning is dangerous? Can you see another detail?
Lightning can destroy a tree or a small house.
Excellent, very clever, good girl, perfect. Okay, so it starts fires and it destroys trees or small houses, excellent. Okay, so we're gonna visualize, close your eyes, everybody. Close your eyes, close your eyes, close your eyes. Okay, I want you to visualize the sound of thunder. And it's really loud and it shakes your house. And you can see flashes of lightning in the dark sky. And they look like zigzags. And you can see all the rain falling down on the rooftops and down the street, causing a big flood. And all the bicycles and motorcycles start floating down the river.
Boom.
Boom. Okay, you can open your eyes. Did anybody have any cool visualizations? What did you
believe? That's me.
Who's that? Oh, let's hear Milk. Milk, what did you visualize?
I visualized my house is sinking, then bikes and cars go bounce into my head, and the thunder go into my body. Then
oh my goodness! So Milk visualized that the lightning struck him and he turned into ash. And I can
Like me too.
Yeah, and I can visualize smoke coming off the ashes. Okay, Taylor, you want to share yours?
I visualize that the people are coming home, and then there was a storm and too noisy. They can't hear the sounds, like you know, beep beep on bus. They can't hear it, and then the water is too high that there is a fish there.
Oh my goodness! What did the fish look like?
The fish look gray and dark, then his eyes look like this.
Oh wow, that's awesome visualization. Good girl. Thank you for sharing. Okay, one more, Duck.
Visualize that it when the water floods in my house, so will not have many fish, so I can take all the fish and make them into food.
Oh, wow. Okay, so you cooked the fish. Ah, okay, nice visualization. And I can visualize you swimming with the fish, Duck. Okay, cool. So let's have a look at our next page. I'm going to ask Misha, can you read page 272?
Houses are chunks of ice that are tossed up and down by the winds of some thunderstorms. Hail can be the size of a marble or larger than a baseball. 5,000 hailstorms strike the United States every year. They can destroy crops and damage buildings and cars.
Awesome, good girl, good reading. Can you show me the size of a marble, everybody? Yeah, so that's, so hailstone is just ice, yeah, balls of ice. Okay, and now can you show me the size of a baseball? So they can get really big, right? A baseball's like that big, maybe about that big. So do you think hailstones are really dangerous, Cherry?
Yes.
Why?
They can make people die.
They can hit you, right? And it's like really hard ice. It can be very, very painful. Yeah, good. Okay, I'm going to read the last
page. I visualize of something.
Okay, wait, Sam, can you read this last page for us for today?
Thunderstorm
sometimes give birth to tornadoes. Inside a storm, a funnel-shaped cloud reaches downward. Winds inside a tornado can spin faster than 300 miles per hour. These winds can lift cars off the ground and rip houses apart.
Good boy.
I realize of hailstone.
Yeah, they're quite dangerous, aren't they? Jack?
I visualized it like there was a man walking through the rain of the hailstone, and then there was one hailstone too big, and then it hit his head, and then the hailstone is too heavy and strong, so it's touched the brain and it's cut the brain off, and then the man died.
Oh my goodness, what a visualization, hey? Wow, okay. Jack, what is the topic of this page, 273? What is this page about? And you can see what word is repeated in that paragraph. What's the topic?
Please tell me about...
Say the topic is...
Tornadoes.
Good boy. Say the topic is tornadoes.
The topic is tornadoes.
Excellent. Good. Okay. And what are some details that describe the tornadoes? Susu.
Winds inside tornado can spin fastest and 300 miles per hour.
Excellent. Yeah. So winds inside a tornado can spin faster than 300 miles per hour. Can everybody make a funnel shape with their hands? So it goes, it's little at the bottom and bigger at the top. Yes. Yeah, so, or you could do it like with your arms, like Ray has done it. So this is the funnel shape. Yeah. So that's another detail, isn't it? It's telling us the shape of the tornado. So they're funnel shaped and they spin faster than 300 miles an hour, and they lift cars off the ground and they rip houses apart. Okay, awesome. So your homework, you're going to read the story three times.